Cello, a good day. We are talking about Casting Crowns, Make Room, featuring Matt Maher. Just for basic chords, I would like to think anyway. We will need a E major, A major, a B major, and a C sharp minor. Thoughts that occurred to me in playing this is it might be kind of fun to explore the idea of just different voicings. If you have a piano player, or maybe you're the secondary guitar player, instead of playing in that low range, you can open it up and get into the slightly higher range with different voicings. Just to be clear on those though, I will spell them out. Give me one second. It looks like this is a little hazy. Maybe it's just me. just to be clear on those chords. E major, open, two, two, one, open, open. The A major, zero, two, two, two. And if you are feeling so inclined, you can include that fifth fret of the high E. Then for the B major, two. I'm sorry, I wasn't being specific with the strings. On the A string, two. Same thing with the A chord, you start on the A, yes. B, two of the A, four, four, four. Wouldn't try and include the high E. Then the C sharp minor, which I often turn minors into sevens. I'll show you both. D four, six, five. Bar the index for four of the high E. If you want to make it minor seven, you just take that pinky away. That's the difference. Carrying on. Those are the four basic chords. I'm gonna go ahead and show you this melody here too. Therefore, you will more or less have all the necessary parts to play the song, and by parts I mean all you got to do is play the chords as they happen, like it's nothing special about it really. Yeah, so that intro lick that happens recurringly, starting on four of the high E with your index to seven with the pinky, I recommend. Four, seven, four, then to the B string, five, four, then five again, then six on the G to four on the G. And as it ends, I would fall to that third. The short place for it to be would be the sixth fret of the D. And it'll sound relative to the E, or it will be relative to the E. One more time, just to add a little more dynamic to that, if you so choose, because with the piano, it sounds very clear that they're playing the E on the fifth fret of the B, the E note, and the E flat or D sharp together. So, like you would want to play the fourth fret of the B and the E open, because that emulates or that is the ability to play both notes at the same time. We can't play two notes on the same string at the same time. So it'd be like, see, I just put emphasis on that fourth fret. You get the idea though. So now moving on, just some different voicings with the capo. This is basically making it so you can change your chord shapes if you know a bunch of open chords already. Most people do. If they don't know bar chords, they usually know some open chords. So now your E would be a D chord. Your A would be a G chord. And actually, just to be further clear, let me reference the chords as they happened in the song. So, verse one here would be a D chord with the capo on two. I didn't specify that. I just assumed you could see it. But capo two, it'd be a D chord here in the verse, then a G chord, then a B chord, B minor for that C sharp. And then it goes back to an A. So the B minor, I mean, we're still playing that same fourth fret that we were before. Same chord, same place. After that C sharp, quote unquote, although it's like a B minor right now. B back to that G shape for the A. Then you go back to the D for the E. And then C sharp. And then now that B chord is now an A chord. And to make that a sus, you would put that ring finger. Well, if you're barring anyway, I tend to bar for the A chord versus using three fingers. So it'd be index barring in the four or two, whichever you like to think of it. And then you'd add that ring on the fifth fret to make it a sus. Like, and it's just using those same chords over and over again. So now, I mean, this being hypothetical, I don't necessarily expect you to use it. But again, if you catch on to the chord shapes and can wrap your mind around, hey, I'm playing a C for an E or whatever, it ain't so bad. But anyhow, now, so capo four, your E would become a C shape. The A would now be an F, depending on how you play your F. I'm trying to reference the verse track again. The C sharp minor would now be an A minor. Then it goes back to the A, which is now an F. And then back to the E, which is now a C. Then to the C sharp minor, which is now an A minor. And then that B chord is now going to be a G. I wouldn't necessarily worry about trying to sus it unless you wanted to play a bar chord. And lastly, what I'm thinking too, I didn't show you the melody line in each of those positions. And then lastly, if you want to get real crazy and start to sound like a mandolin up here on the ninth fret, you'd be way on 12 and play your E is now a G shape. And then the A is now a C. And then back to, then now your C sharp minor is an E chord, actually. Then back to the A. Then back to the E. Then to the C sharp again. And then now your B chord is now a D. And I'm flashing through those, assuming that you know all those different chords I just mentioned. But yeah, just in the event that you want to use any of those, I am going to give you the lead line there. So actually, the back to capo two, the lead melody would more or less be the same, but you wouldn't have the ability of hitting the open E anymore. So it'd have to just be straightened up. So same exact thing, same exact shape. Then we had capo four. We could do open. So it'd be open E, 0, 3, 0, then one to the B, because the strings are still the same. B, B, so one open, two open, and then if we were finishing it, it'd be two open, two of the D. So one more time. Messed up. I kind of like that one because it, if you can keep your hand off of it anyway, it allows the notes to ring out. Sounds kind of cool. Again, this is all experimental. Things you could do. I'm realizing I actually skipped a position. I skipped the seventh fret, but that's okay. Lastly here, this one is a little trickier. If we were on fret number 9, so it'd be 13 of the G to 12 of the B, and then 14, 13 on the D, back to the 14, 13, 11, and then open, or 9. So I'm messing that up. It doesn't go to the 13. 14 straight to the 11. So and then you fall to that 11 of the A, ultimately, for the second time around. Now, having gone through all that, I'm going to play along with this. And I don't know, I just purely for the sake of jumping around, I think what I'm going to do, just so you can see and maybe hear all the different chords, I'm going to try to jump around in real time with the capo. So I'm going to start with it off of.
Door. It was for this a child was born, to save a world so cold and hollow. A sleeping town they did not know, that lying in a manger alone, a savior king who had no home has come.
You know why I'm messing it up?
Is there room in your heart?
Because I'm not really looking at the chord chart. I don't really have it under my fingers. I'm going to back that up a little bit. Actually, I'm just going to back it up to the top and play the second position. Just so you see it here, whatever. Here we go, same thing, but I'm looking at the chord chart this time and confusing myself, telling me that it's other chords. Come much, maybe a little shorter. This is, forgive me, I recognize this is not my best performance. Again, I was kind of flying through it, recognizing that it was, generally speaking, pretty easy. Like, I'm jumping around a whole lot and whatnot, too, and that was really just a thought before I started recording. Hey, we could go to all these different places. So now here, I don't think I showed you the melody here. Saying that because I don't think I can do it myself. So yeah, in the end, this is why I don't use capos, because you start getting confused. But again, with practice, it could be much smoother, and it might be something that you can add into your arsenal of playing. You get the idea. I don't even want to carry on because I keep messing it up. But yeah, explore with all those different things. I am noticing, getting back into that melody line there, after the chorus, or let me say chorus is, cause it happens again. It is, kind of tricky and on, like on an offbeat, sounds different than when it first started at the beginning of the song, as far as its placement. But yeah, work it out. That's what we do, right? Yep. I hope this is helpful. And till we meet again, rock on.